The photographs in this film were taken in the remote southern Andes of Peru more than 50 years ago and form part of the first comprehensive photographic record that was ever made of the Indian world of the heirs of the Incas. 450 years after the Spanish conquest of Peru, the Indians still tenaciously maintain their most ancient traditions. At the ice festival of Collieriti, the Indians trek to the highest source of water in a pilgrimage whose origins go back thousands of years. They ritually carry blocks of ice back to their faraway villages in an act of penance and homage to the mountains and the sun. Martin Chanby was uniquely placed to document the ways of the people of the Andes, since he was an Indian himself. His photographs were a political as well as an artistic statement, and despite his humble origins, he became a prominent member of a group of intellectuals known as the Indigenista movement, who brought the dominant European classes of Peru face to face with a culture they had long ignored. During the making of this film, many new photographs were reprinted from the original negatives and are now being shown again for the first time since they were taken. The archive of Chanby's work, which is kept in the city of Cusco, is now looked after by his daughter Julia, who is also a photographer.
Ah, eso nos decía, siempre decían. Hijos, yo no dejo plata, pero les dejo una mina en todo este archivo. Ustedes tienen que saberla cuidar, cuidarla mucho, mucho, mucho y elevarla un poco más de lo que yo la he elevado.
Chanby died in 1973 and left behind some 20,000 glass plate negatives dating from the early years of the century, the work of a lifetime as a professional photographer. The recent discovery and research of this enormous archive have led to a series of major exhibitions, beginning at the Museum of Modern Art in New York, which have introduced his work to the rest of the world. His extraordinary use of natural light and his unique view of the whole of Peruvian society, of the heirs of the conquerors, as well as the heirs of the Incas, have established Chanby's reputation as perhaps the most important pioneer of Latin American photography.
Chanby, lógicamente, era un hombre muy cariñoso, un señor en todas sus actividades. Era muy retraído a su arte, era un hombre profundamente dado a la fotografía. Con los medios que había ese entonces, ¿no? Sus máquinas eran las más primitivas todavía. La iluminación de fotografías era preciosa, había verdaderas obras de arte, ya representaban una especie de pinturas sobre fotografía. Y cariño profundo por el indio, sobre todo. Era un cariño especial a su raza. Y por supuesto, no al movimiento indigenista que nosotros representábamos en el Cusco.
Thank you.
Chambi picture, Chambi's work, was as interesting in the 20s as today, because it's the main testimony, a remarkable testimony of a life, of a series of customs, of interrelation between people and the ecological environment, which is the very basis of our national identity. We have been a country which has been watching towards the Pacific Ocean and towards Europe for a long time, since 1532 when the conquerors came. And Chambi has helped us to see our country, to see ourselves, to have the possibility to stop to be a foreigners in our own country.
It was into the closed Indian world of the Andes that Martin Chambi was born in the village of Coasa in 1891. He came from a traditional peasant campesino family who worked and lived from the land.
Él contaba de que muy niño él en su pueblo, en Coasa, estando en escuela, llegó una compañía inglesa ahí a Coasa a lavar oro. El chico curioso de colegio se iba ahí a mirar qué cosas hacían los gringos ahí. Y vio, pues, ¿no?, que había un señor con un trípode que cargaba. Y le llamó mucho la atención la fotografía, porque incluso en esa fecha él nos contaba, decía, ¿no?, a mí uno de esos señores me tomó una foto y me la enseñó al rato. Y mi padre se la guardaba, la fotografía. Y bueno, yo siempre pensaba en la fotografía. Nunca me olvidé de esa foto y de la idea de ver cómo sacaban fotos. Tomaban fotos, veía yo mi pueblo en las fotografías que tomaba el señor este.
Fascinated by the idea of photography, Chambi left his small village for the nearby city of Arequipa at the age of 14 and found work as an apprentice in a photographic studio frequented by the Europeanized upper classes. This was the first of his many self-portraits. He willingly exchanged his simple rural existence for the modern profession of photographer. In 1919, at the age of 29, Chambi decided to broaden his horizons. With his young family, he traveled to the city of Cusco, the ancient capital of the Inca Empire, which stands almost 12,000 feet above sea level. He was to live and work there for the rest of his life. The striking Spanish architecture of Cusco rests on Inca foundations. The conquistadors destroyed the palaces that stood around the main square and forced the Indians to turn the old stones into Catholic churches. But at the festival of Corpus Christi, the saints are paraded in exactly the same way that the Incas used to parade the mummified bodies of their dead rulers. Catholic effigies are made from the gold and silver which was looted from Inca shrines in the name of Christ. And it is this mixture of the Catholic and the Andean, of the native underneath the Spanish, that is the key to Chambi's work. Cusco has long ceased to be the capital of an empire. but its unique traditions have flourished because of its isolated position in the mountains. Chanbi arrived at a time when the city was being opened up to the ideas and inventions of the 20th century, and he enthusiastically documented the new technology, of which he, as a photographer, was himself a product. Through his commercial photography, Chanbi made his name in Cusco, and every member of his large family was drawn into the business, which they still run today. By the mid-1920s, he had the best studio in the city.
Mi papá era en su trabajo muy organizado, muy cumplido y era muy responsable. Y también quería que nosotros seamos así puntuales, responsables sobre todo, ¿no? No permitía, digamos, que tengamos otros quehaceres, sino en el trabajo siempre. Y siempre una cosa que recuerdo de él es que decía, primero es la obligación que la devoción. Mi trabajo fue en el laboratorio. Revelar rollos, hacer postales, ¿no? Que durante esos años que trabajé con él hacíamos postales por miles.
Porque claro, el negocio no era demasiado extenso, no era muy grande. Como decía mi hermana, era la venta de películas, los trabajos que llevaban, por decirlo, los turistas, los retratos que se hacían, todo. Y él preparó, digamos así, su galería. En la casa que ocupaba, él hizo una galería especializada para tomar sobre todo los retratos, que en una época se dedicó ampliamente a eso.
The majority of the photographs were taken on large glass plate cameras using only natural light. Chanbi developed the technique to an extraordinary degree of sophistication, controlling the light by means of thick adjustable curtains and retouching detail in the negative. One of Chanbi's assistants in the early 1930s was Cesar Mesa, who now runs his own studio in Cusco.
Esta cámara, muy simple, la utilizaba para tomar fotografías de carnet. Les debo confesar esto. En ese tiempo, el señor Chanbi, el señor González, que eran los mejores estudios que había en el Cusco, cobraban por la media docena de fotografías tamaño carnet un sol con 50 centavos. Yo, desconocido, muchacho, y todavía, desde luego, no inexperto, principiante, ¿cómo podía competir con ellos? ¿De qué manera? Me dije, pues haciendo más barato. Bueno, no tenía ingresos, tenía que buscar trabajo. Entonces, así donde acudo a casa del señor Chanbi, ofreciéndole mis trabajos. Él me dice, bueno, ¿cómo no? ¿Usted quiere trabajar conmigo? Encantado. Veremos, a ver, usted sabe, veremos.
Chanbi Chambi moved among a group of middle-class artists and intellectuals known as the Indigenistas, who used to meet in the bars, restaurants, and open-air chicherias of Cusco. The Indigenistas were united by a conviction that the true spirit of Peru lay with the indigenous Indian population, and as such, they were part of a movement common to many Latin American countries at the beginning of the century.
Chambi era un hombre cuya personalidad estaba formada por dos grandes dotes, la sencillez y la sinceridad. Por eso era Chambi un artista muy querido por los intelectuales del Cusco, por estas sus virtudes.
Se hacía el que no veía ir.
Oye, localiza, amigo, yo hubiera querido estar allí.
It was basically an intellectual movement, which tried to combat all that old colonial versions that the Indians were a sort of second-class ethnic group. They painted the Indians, they took pictures like Chambi, they wrote stories, novels. It was a massive production which showed the first group of collective interest for this population, which conformed the majority of the country, but which was considered, you know, as I told, a second class ethnic group in the country.
Desde el año de 1926, comenzaron a visitar los artistas de las diferentes latitudes de Sudamérica al Cusco. Y estos pintores, músicos, etcétera, eran mensajes vivos del nuevo pensamiento americano y venían hacia el Cusco, se juntaba con la juventud estudiosa en unas fiestas espirituales inolvidables. En esos momentos sale en 1930, si la memoria no me traiciona, la obra No el Nuevo Indio de Uriel García.
Uriel García, with his book The New Indian, became one of the central figures around which this generation of Cusco intellectuals gathered. García was a professor at the university and a sympathizer with the newly formed Peruvian Communist Party. He and his group transmitted their ideas through meetings, pamphlets, and above all their newspapers and periodicals, such as El Sol, for which Chambi took numerous photographs. The Indigenistas' activities tended to be artistic and literary, rather than directly political, and their support for the Indian was fundamentally theoretical. They came mostly from the professional classes, and Chambi, as a true Indian, was unique among them.
Era un indio, un señor indio. Este es el calificativo que le dio. Era indio legítimo, pero era un señor indio. Porque los indios, ¿no?, han tenido un sentido moral único siempre. Somos los mestizos y los blancos los que les han malogrado el sentido moral de los indios.
The marriage of the European and the native has produced the mestizos, a local term for those of mixed race. Although somewhat westernized, the mestizos have retained the Quechua language and remain close to Indian values. For example, they still eat traditional foods like the guinea pig. Chambi was at home in their world, and through his photographs, he informed the Indigenista intellectuals of the true nature of the culture they were trying to promote. The mestizo world of Cusco was believed by the Indigenistas to be most alive in the open-air taverns known as chicherias. Here, the indigenistas could meet Indians, get drunk with them, and cultivate their idea of Indianness. Consequently, the chicheria came to take on an almost mystical significance, so much so that Uriel Garcia rather romantically described it as the very heart of the Peruvian culture. By this time, Chambi's work had gone beyond the confines of his studio and postcard business. He was pioneering a documentary style, combining the aesthetic he had developed through his commercial work with a day-to-day life on his own doorstep. In this way, he resembled the Indian artists of previous ages, like the painters of the 18th century who were trained to decorate Cusco's churches. The cathedral has a native version of the Last Supper, but instead of the lamb and the bread, the apostles are about to eat a guinea pig. As well as trying to learn more about the lives of contemporary Indians, the indigenistas tried to bring about a renaissance of the glories of the Inca past. Chambi began to document all the Inca remains in Cusco, which were too massive and well constructed for the Spanish to dismantle. He also photographed Indians from the countryside who had found their way to the city, building up a comprehensive record of the Indian types, as he called them, living in the Cusco region.
Nosotros, compatriotas del Cusco, tenemos la dicha y la felicidad de ser una sociedad con estirpe, de ser una sociedad cuyos orígenes se pierden en la leyenda más fértil que pudo dar América. América se sintetiza en el Cusco, no solo de la esperanza, sino de la acción de todos nosotros. Cuando andamos por las calles del Cusco, cuando recordamos nuestros viejos ancestros, nosotros, compatriotas del Cusco, tenemos un pasado glorioso que hay que fortalecer, no reivindicar. Pero no olvidemos que Belgrano y que Mitre reclamaron para el Cusco la capitalidad de esta parte que no tiene fronteras, que es la América Morena. Causachum Cusco. Salud por ustedes.
Despite the indigenista sentiments of today's Marxist mayor, Cusco still has a very westernized upper class, and inevitably, now as then, power is in their hands. As a photographer, Chambi regularly covered the parties and gatherings of Cusco society, and his scrutiny of their life offers a sharp contrast with his pictures of the humble chicherias. It was this freedom of movement on both sides of the social divide that enabled him to build such a comprehensive portrait of Cusco life. There was tremendous wealth for the small hacendado class of European settlers who owned land or were involved in financing the growing textile industry around Cusco. They often commissioned Chambi to take portraits of them in their fine homes, but he made a point of including in these photographs the Indians upon whom the bourgeoisie depended for their comfortable existence.